The unemployment rate is finally coming down here in the U.S., but part of the problem with it is the number itself is kind of rigged because it leaves out people that have quit looking for jobs and also people that would like a full-time job that can't find one that are working part-time, which is still a very tough economic situation. But what's going on here is like around the world, all businesses now that compete with the international trade and so many other countries that have lower wage bases, companies have just been having to cut costs every way they possibly can, including labor. Otherwise, they just can't compete in the international marketplace. So the wars have contributed to that somewhat, primarily in terms of they've diverted huge amounts of money into the defense industry, where a lot of the stuff just gets wasted and there's no long-term value. And if all that money had gone into infrastructure, the number of long-lasting jobs and the bigger bang for the buck, people can get a lot more money out of an expensive bridge than an expensive aircraft carrier, or I'd probably say an expensive 10 bridges. So you have a growing interest amongst a lot of folks, even in the military, that that they see tremendous expenses in military, particularly overseas, have hurt the economic situation at home. And we have the problem now of people having to work when they're retired, which everyone else is trying to do. And we also had a little bit of a social situation here, where we're such a big consumer society that even everybody, people of modest incomes, children of families with modest incomes, they're constantly inundated with consumerism, and we had fairly easy credit here. A lot of people developed very poor spending habits, getting into debt. Kids think nothing of going to college and running up debts of $50,000, $100,000, and everybody kind of forgot the common sense that you're going to have to pay for this someday. So there was a social aspect of this, of enjoy now and pay later, which also has contributed to the problem. And of course, that happened in Europe and many other places. So that's a big component. And then three, we've had a continuing corruption problem. As companies get bigger and bigger and bigger, the donations and the politics get bigger and bigger. They've been able to change the laws, sometimes very slowly over like a 10-year period of time, that business mechanisms that used to be illegal, they have actually made them legal now, so that when they get caught for something, about the worst thing that they're looking at is having to pay fines, which the stockholders of the companies pay. But if we go back to our current debacle that we've had here in the States with the mortgage, the derivatives problems and whatever, I think to date there hasn't been a single, not one person's been indicted. They haven't had a single criminal prosecution. So it's almost a wild, wild west once you get into high finance. But that's the economic and the unemployment side of it. Moving along to the article on that I saw on Panorama, that was a video clip that got my attention, of the little girl. They were talking about not having dinner at home, kids eating on the school lunch program, sometimes the school breakfast program. Kids went home, and they said there were times when their parents had absolutely no money, no food, and they didn't have dinner. And one little six-year-old girl just broke my heart, and she said, when they asked what her situation was, and to my shock, she said, "Mom fixed rats." And it just hit me like a ton of bricks. Fortunately, they're not eating those a lot, but folks that are becoming homeless, been out of work, they're working part-time, they're sometimes living day-to-day, they run out of dough, and we have kids that are eating without any dinner. But a lot of that poverty, a big thing that's hidden about poverty here, Most of it is due to family breakups. Children living in poverty are typically shut down. One or two fathers not home. Mothers sometimes have children from two or three fathers. And you have very little poverty in families where you have a family unit, a mother and father together. All the big numbers where people here make a big deal of our poverty numbers, the vast majority are single mothers with children, which without two parents supporting a family, it's and everything's so expensive here, it puts you in the poverty situation. So the whole big solution to poverty is not to have everybody get divorced and reduce the small numbers of the huge numbers of mothers taking care of kids with no dads at home.